Hey, what's up everybody and welcome back to Gal. In this video, we're gonna have fun and we're gonna do a multi-camera video edit. Now I've shown you guys how to do a multi-camera edit before. This time we're gonna have fun and have it be a music video. Now the same techniques apply. You can have multiple cameras set up. You can see I have another camera angle set up, kind of behind the scenes shot. I have another side angle here. And Premiere Pro's multi-camera feature allows you to synchronize all of these camera angles so that way when you cut away, it's at the exact moment when I'm saying these exact words on the other camera and then on the other camera as well. Now, a lot of you guys have asked me, how do you color grade multi-camera angles? Because it's a little bit tricky. Now, I'm gonna show you how to do that in the tutorial, but first, we're gonna have fun and do a little music video shoot with a song that I got from SongTrader called Burgundy. Now, SongTrader is a really cool music licensing platform. Just like others, you can use it to browse by genre, vocals, different moods, but better yet, anybody around the world, musicians around the world, can upload and license their music. And you can follow these artists. So you can go to their unique page, you can follow their music, and better yet, this is my favorite part, is that you can leave them tips. So you can say, hey, I appreciate your work, and leave that artist a tip, which is really cool. So what I've done is I've chosen Burgundy, I went through their list, I thought it was super cool, and better yet, I was able to download an MP3 without a watermark before I started the edit, so I could be sure that this was the song that I wanted to use in this video before I went ahead and licensed it. So I reached out to the SongTrader team and they sponsored this video and they also hooked you guys up with a 10% off promo code. You guys can get that code in my description box below and use my link to sign up for SongTrader and start browsing music and downloading the MP3s without a watermark for free today. So without further ado, let's go ahead and start shooting our music video. And I've made all of this footage as well as the 1 minute remix version of Burgundy in my description box below so you guys can follow along during the edit. And now let's go ahead and shoot the music video. So let's get this shit in gear. So inside of my project panel here, I have the 6 different angles that we shot for this music video. Now, one thing that's important to note is that on each angle, I had the music playing in the background while I was lip syncing. So each one of these angles has the full 60-second song. They're different durations, but they all have the full length of the song for that particular angle. And we have the Burgundy 60-second remix track here that is the track that we want to be the audio when we synchronize all of these to make the multi-camera sequence. Now, to follow along, you can download all of these assets to make your own multi-camera sequence. So what I'm going to do to create the multi-camera sequence is select the WAV file here, then I'm going to hit Shift, and then I'm going to select Angle 1, and then I'm going to Control-click and create multi-camera source sequence. In this new window, I'm going to give it a custom name and I'm going to call it music video. Now this is where we synchronize. For this, we're just gonna use the default here. We're going to use audio track channel 1 and this will use the Burgundy 60 remix.wav file as the main audio file. And then for sequence presets, I'm just gonna leave this as is and then I'm going to hit OK. Now what this did is it put all of the angles in the audio file in this processed clips folder, and we have a music video multi-camera source sequence. Now what I'm going to do is just drag and drop this inside of the timeline, and this is where we can begin to edit. Now all of the angles are inside of this one layer. Right now, if we scrub through, it's black in the beginning because not all of the clips started with video. But as I scrub through, you can see that we start to see video. Now to see all the other angles inside of this, click on the toggle multi-camera view. And now you can see we have our 6 angles here. If you do not see this button, just click on button editor and drag this multi-camera view into your button tool area here. So all of the angles you see in this multi-camera view are synced with this audio track. So then we can easily begin to make a rough cut by switching between these angles without having to worry about dragging different layers. So the way this works is each camera angle, you can click to switch, of course, but each one of these is assigned a numerical value. So this is number one, this is 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So you can press the number keys to switch. So I can hit 2 and it goes to 2, number 3 and it goes to 3. I can tap 4, 5, and 6. So that's how you switch between them. Now to make actual cuts, Premiere Pro can record the cuts as you play it back and hit the different numerical values. So what I'm going to do is just watch the video back, hit the number keys to create a rough cut of what I want the music video to look like. And of course, you can change these cuts at any time, which I will show you after I'm done recording the cuts. So first in the opening here, I'm just going to roll this back before the music starts. So you can see the waveform begins right here. I'm going to hit C on my keyboard to cut there, and then V again to go back to the selection tool and delete that bit off. So now we're ready to go. The first video that I want to show is number 2. So I'm gonna start on number 2 and then I'm gonna hit play and hit the different camera angles I want to show at different times, and Premiere Pro will record those as cuts. So now when I hit stop, you can see all the cuts were made and recorded when I hit the keypad. Now I'm going to go to the final music video that I created here, and let me double click to open this up. And one thing to note is you can change the height of your video so you can see the different cuts here. Now if I zoom in, you can see the different video clips and you can see what angle it cut to. So you can see here it's angle 6 and here it's angle 1. So that helps you see what angle it is. If you ever wanted to change what angle is being displayed at this moment, just simply switch by clicking which angle you want to switch to, and it automatically switches and you can see that changed instantly. So I'm just going to switch back here. If you do not see the names here, just be sure to go to the wrench tool and show video names, and this will help you see what angles it was cut to. Another thing you can do, if you want to adjust where this cut takes place, it's really easy to do. Simply hit N on your keyboard to go to the rolling edit tool, and you can move this edit to any point in the future or farther in the beginning in the timeline, at any point you want. So it's really easy to modify all the cuts that you recorded to refine your edit. So once you have all your edits in place, you can also just select a clip here, go back to the selection tool, and you can zoom in and out by using the effect controls here. So you can scale in if you like, you can move it over, and so on. So you can really play around with the motion controls here to refine your edit. Another thing that you can do is you can color correct. Now you can color correct at an individual level, such as selecting this angle, then using Lumetri Color, let's say curves, to increase the exposure. But this is only increasing the exposure at this one cut. if you want to adjust the color settings of the entire master clip, so future instances of this have the same effects, this is where you actually color grade at the master level. So I'm just gonna hit Command Z to undo that and delete Lumetri Color from this clip here. So this is where we go to the master clip. So I'm gonna open up Process Clips, double click to open up Angle 1, and from here I'm gonna go to Effects, and I'm gonna search for Lumetri Color. I'm going to drag and drop Lumetri Color on this source angle 1, and then under Effect Controls you can see we have Lumetri Color. Now if we go back to angle 1, we can now use Lumetri Color, and you can see that we're editing the master angle 1.mp4. So here I'm just going to move the exposure level over, and you can see that it's brightening the entire angle 1 over here. So this is great because now all instances, when we cut to angle 1, it will be brighter. And you can add many other different corrections too. I like to add some vignettes so I can increase the vignette around the edges, a little bit of feathering. And what you can do is then you can go through every single angle that you want to color correct. So for example, angle number 2 here, same thing. We'll go to Effects. Then we'll drag and drop Lumetri Color. And now you can see we're editing angle 2. And we can go to this angle here in the timeline so you can see what it looks like. So angle 2, we need to go back. See how it switched to Final Music Video? We want to go back to angle 2. So double click. And now we can start to make edits to this. And let's go to curves and let's increase the exposure just a little bit. And let's add a vignette around the edges. Increase the feathering. And underneath creative, we can increase the vibrancy a little bit. And so on. So this is the way that you would go through each different angle to color correct it. And you can apply some creative looks. So if you wanted to add one of these camera filters here, let's try the 2395. It gives it more of a film dreamy look, which I like, and you can change the intensity of it. And you can apply these same effects to the different camera angles too. So if you wanted to copy and paste this look, what you can do is double click on angle 2, go to Effect Controls, and hit Command C to copy this Lumetri Color, and then on angle 3, you can go to Effect Controls and hit Command V to paste it. And you can see the same look was applied to angle 3. Now we can go to angle 4, Command V to paste it. Same look was applied to camera angle 4. Now let's go to angle 5, paste it. And let's go to angle 6, go to Effect Controls, Command V. And now we can go back to angle 1. We can delete the Lumetri Color that we had before, and we can hit Command V to paste the look. So now they all have this sort of film-like look. And, you know, this is just a rough edit, but this was just a way to give them the same look. So from this point on, you can then start to add transitions and other effects. And that's how you can get started faster with a multi-camera music video shoot. So I hope that you guys had fun in this video. I encourage you guys to use this method of editing, it'll make it a lot smoother to edit your music videos or your interview footage. Whichever one you want to use, you can apply the same technique. And if you want to see how to do it with dialogue, just a reminder, you can watch my other tutorial and I'll put a card up here so you guys can click and watch that video. Thanks again to SongTrader for sponsoring. Be sure to use the promo code in the description box below to get 10% off and start following artists there and leave them some tips if you find their music awesome. So that's all for this video, you guys, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.